Gentleman from Connecticut is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise with a certain amount of outrage tonight because we are debating a resolution that, just to remind this House, expresses the sense of the House of Representatives that all people of the United States should participate in a moment of silence to reflect upon the service and sacrifice of members of the United States Armed Forces, both at home and abroad. A noble thing, a good thing, that we would honor our veterans who day in, day out put their lives on the line for the freedom and safety of every single American. And the minority stands here tonight and brings their politics into this resolution. I cannot remember a moment. I will not yield. I cannot remember a moment.
You're not going to yield, but you're going to miss out all this discussion.
So be smirched.
The gentleman from Connecticut controls the floor.
My friend wants to have a discussion. I wanted to offer one to him.
The gentleman from Connecticut controls the floor.
Gentleman recognized. I will yield to the gentleman when I have completed my statement. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm appalled that at this moment when we are here to honor our veterans, party would bring their politics and their misinformation. And though I am appalled, while we are talking about veterans, I will not stand here while that misinformation is peddled. A bill made in darkness, if I might quote my friend on the other side of the aisle. This bill has been discussed for months, for years, for decades. This debate has raged. 120 Republican amendments included in this. This thing posted in the House and in the Senate, and now for the requisite 72 hours. And they call that darkness. Increasing the deficit. The nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office, respected by both sides, has indicated clearly, down to many significant figures, that this will be the largest reduction in the deficit ever engineered by this House. In excess of $100 billion in the first 10 years, in excess of $1 trillion in the second 10 years. We're hearing the same misinformation about 6 years of benefits for 10 years of taxation. How's this? Shortly after this bill's enactment, children will no longer be denied coverage because of pre-existing conditions. Shortly after this bill's passage, how's this for 6 years of benefits? Our seniors will experience immediately a reduction in the donut hole that has forced them in instances to choose between food and drugs shortly after passage of this bill. Shortly after the passage of this bill, young people up to the age of 26 will be able to go on their parents' insurance. 6 years of benefits with 10 years of taxation. This is outrageous misinformation made all the worse by the fact that the minority chooses to bring this up at this moment when we are here to honor the sacrifice of our proud veterans. I yield to my gentleman on the other, to my friend on the other side.
From Kansas is recognized.
I thank the gentleman.
Georgia, I apologize.
I will proudly take Kansas, Mr. Speaker, Georgia, whichever. I thank the gentleman for yielding, and although we haven't worked together on any committees, I know you by reputation, and I know that your reputation is good and that you are known to be a fair representative. So one of my concerns, I just have to tell you, as somebody who served in the minority and in the majority, and oftentimes in the majority felt that we ran roughshod over the minority and that it was the wrong thing to do. But I also know that when you're in the minority and you don't get to offer, for example, a single amendment on the largest piece of legislation that we faced maybe since the income tax debate, I would appeal to your sense of understanding why you and I have this discussion going on, because I support this bill, and I certainly think a moment of silence is a fit and proper thing to do, and I look forward to traveling with the gentleman, not just to Iraq and Afghanistan, but actually to some of the places where we have World War II soldiers buried in foreign lands, and I can tell you they absolutely love Americans as they look at the graves of Americans that are all over the world protecting not just our freedom but their freedom. So I think that I certainly understand why you are appalled that we are using this as a vehicle to discuss health care. So, you know, I agree with you. There is a good sense of indignation, yet I find myself in a few minutes one of these people who will be talking about health care because it's my only opportunity. Because as I understand it, we're going to have 1 hour debate on two different pieces of legislation, 30 minutes per side, and if you're not directly on the health care committee, you won't have an opportunity to speak tomorrow. That's why, while I support this legislation,
I thank the gentleman for bringing the discussion back to its proper topic of the honoring that this House and that the people of America can do for our veterans. I thank the gentleman for that, and would like to note to this gentleman that I spent this morning fighting to make sure that we would vote on the bill in an up-and-down fashion, and in fact, that is what we will do. And I will note to the gentleman that he has had ample opportunity to discuss this over many, many months, but again, I thank him for bringing this discussion back to where it should be, which is debating whether and how we honor our veterans. With that, I yield back to the chair.
Gentleman yields back.